Hi everyone, in our today's topic we will going to discuss about the Ganymede. Ganymede is solar system's 9th largest object and the Jupiter's largest moon. And recently the Hubble telescope found out the water vapor in its atmosphere. As the scientists have found out the water vapor in its atmosphere, that is why the scientists have came to a conclusion that the life can be lived over there. Maybe the life is over there, maybe the life not been over there. It is the part of our research, part of the research of the scientist. We have not yet came to a conclusion that whether the life is over there or not. But it is very important to us to know about the Ganymede. Because why it is so important? Because in 2017, the UPSC has asked about the Juno's missions, the Juno's Jupiter missions. They mixed the questions with the Earth origin to the Juno's findings about the Jupiter. So that is why this topic is very much important. And we will going to discuss lately that why the Ganymede is in the news, that I have already told in our introductions. And the before going into any questions, before going into these questions answers, we will going to briefly discuss what the Ganymede is, what the Ganymede is made up of, and what kind of things the Ganymede actually given us to our the solar system to explore the things about the moons of our largest planet. So Ganymede is a satellite of Jupiter, is the largest and the most massive of the solar system. It is the 9th largest object in solar system, and it is the largest without a substantial atmosphere. It has a diameter of 5,268 km, making it 26% larger than the planet Mercury by volume. Although it is only 45% as massive as Mercury is. It has the lowest moments of inertia factor of any solid body in the solar system, and is the only moon known to have a magnetic field likely created through the convection without the liquid iron core. Outward from the Jupiter, it is the 7th satellite and the 3rd of the Galilean moon. It is composed of approximately equal amount of silicate rock and water. It is fully differentiated body with an iron-rich liquid core and internal ocean that may contain the more water than all of the Earth's ocean combined. And now the questions arises that what is the Galilean moons? There are four Galilean moons which were discovered by the Galileo Galilei. Ganymede is one of them. The four moons of the Jupiter was Io, Ganymede, Europa and Callisto. They were the first seen by the Galileo Galilei in December 1609 or in January 1610, and they recognized by him as the satellites of the Jupiter in March 1610. The four Galilean moon were the only moons of the Jupiter until the discovery of Amalthea, the fifth moon of the Jupiter in 1892. They contain 99.99% of total mass in orbit around the Jupiter. So here we will going to discuss about briefly about these four moons. What are the characteristics of these four moons? Io. Io is the innermost moon of Jupiter, and it is the most actively volcanic moon in the solar systems. There's more than 400 volcanoes. And Europa? Europa is an icy giant. Europa is an icy giant. It has an albedo of more than 60%. And Ganymede, that we are already discussing about the Ganymede. And Callisto. Callisto is also an silicate and the ice giant whose albedo is less than 20% or near about 20%. So now we will going to discuss that how the name of the Ganymede came, after which god the name actually came from. Now we will go through its naming discovery by the Galileo Galilei. The name was suggested by astronomer Simon Marius after the mythological Ganymede, a Trojan prince desired by the Zeus, who carried him off to be the cupbearer of the gods. This is how the Ganymede name came from. The Greek gods. Actually, the Galileo belongs to the Greece. So the name after this, these moons were given after the Greek gods. The Ganymede is an, there is an interesting fact is that the Ganymede is a tidally locked planet. So what does the tidally locked mean? The tidally locked means it's one side facing towards the planet, hence its day is 7 days and the 3 months. And the Ganymede orbits Jupiter at a distance of 1,070,400 km. And the third among the Galilean satellite, for every orbit of the Ganymede, Europa orbits twice and the Io orbits 4 times. The Ganymede surface density is 1.936 gram per centimeter cube, which actually suggests that it composed of equal part of rocky material and mostly the water ice. Some water is in the liquid form. Its surface has an albedo of about 43%. What does albedo mean? Albedo means the amount of sunlight hits the surface of any objects. When the sunlight hits that object, some of being absorbed by that object and some being emitted by that object. The amount of sunlight is being emitted by object, that is called the albedo. So in case of Ganymede, 43% of the total sunlight is being reflected by the Ganymede. That is why albedo is 43%. And the next question is very important, which is that when we came to know that the Ganymede has the ocean of surface, ocean of water under the ice cover surface. In the 1970s, the NASA scientists first suspected that Ganymede has a thick ocean between the two layers of ice, one on the surface and the one beneath, a liquid ocean and atop the rocky mantle. In the 1990s, NASA Galileo mission flyby Ganymede and found indications of such as subsurface oceans. In March 2015, the scientists reported that the measurement with the Hubble Space Telescope of how the aurora moved confirmed that the Ganymede had subsurface moon. A large saltwater ocean affects the Ganymede magnetic field and consequently its aurora. The evidence suggests that the Ganymede's oceans might be the largest in entire solar systems. The Europa has also oceans. Callisto may have, but the Ganymede's oceans is one of the, it might be the largest. So then why the Ganymede recently in the news? Because recently the Ganymede came to a news because firstly our scientists speculated that the Ganymede has the potential to sustain the life. Now the Hubble proves that the speculations the scientists actually have is actually right. Recently, the Hubble finds the first evidence of the water vapor at Ganymede. The water vapor forms when the ice from the moon's surface sublimates. This is from the solid to the gas. Actually, the Ganymede is too far from the sun. Its surface temperature is -100 to -300 degrees centigrade. So how the water will going to get vaporized? So there is a no chance that water will going to get vaporized. The only chance it can sublimates from solid forms to the vapor forms, because the amounts of heat it gets from its surrounding and from gets from its mother planet Jupiter, it is actually concentrated into an equator. In the equator gets some heats, and in equator that heats actually helps the water to sublimate. So this is how the water vapor actually evaporates from the equator and gets into the atmosphere. The whatever the atmosphere, they actually do not have the atmosphere. So that water vapor actually creates that atmosphere. So next questions we arises that the how did they find the water on the atmosphere? How the scientists found out the water in the atmosphere? They not found out the water hurriedly. They are actually doing the experiments on Ganymede since the 1998. In the 1998, the space telescope imagining spectrograph of the Hubble took the first ultraviolet pictures of Ganymede. By studying the emission, researcher noted that the Ganymede has a permanent magnetic field and some atomic oxygen. In 2018, the Hubble Cosmic Origins spectrograph, the instrument was used to measure the amount of this atomic oxygen. The study team combined the data from the 1998, 2010, 2018, and to their surprise noted some contrast to the original findings. Actually, the Ganymede was scanned by some of the objects that we sent from Earth. Among them, the Juno, the New Horizon, the Voyager 1 and the 2. They took the pictures of the Ganymede and sent it to the Earth and they helped the scientists to find out what the Ganymede is made up of and what is going on in Ganymede. Then what are the future missions that we actually planned for the Ganymede? The world further will going to found out the Ganymede. The European Space Agency's JUICE missions, JUICE, JUICE missions, or the full form of the JUICE is Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, which they will going to launch in 2022. It will arrive at the Jupiter in 2029 and spend 3 years observing the giant planet and its three largest moons. Three largest moon means Io, Europa and Ganymede. The Ganymede will be included in this survey, and the researcher hope to learn more about the moon as a potential habitat for life. Maybe it is impossible for the life being thrive over there because the temperature is very, very low. It is -300 degrees centigrade. So Fahrenheit, -300 degree Fahrenheit, which is very, very low in centigrade, is -100 to -180. It is very much impossible to life being thrive. Maybe some bacteria and the viruses be able to sustain that extreme temperatures over there. So in our last slide, we will going to discuss about our questions. The questions the UPSC asked in 2017 related to the Jupiter's missions. That is the how the Juno's missions help understanding the Earth origin. So from these topics, maybe the UPSC will going to ask that is our questions, which is that how the Ganymede's water vapor discovery help us to find the origin of the life on Earth. If you guys are very much interested to write the answer to us, then please write your answer to the given email address, which is tuhin.power.academy@gmail.com. Thank you very much. Thank you very much if you will going to listen to our topic.